But speaking of people voting, you know, when you get close to the ballot, you're supposed to be the underdog, aren't you? Because in America, it's not compulsory to vote. So you really need to mobilise people to get out there. So the last thing you want is for people to think you're a shoo-in, because then, well, why would I bother going out into the, you know, out and voting if you're going to already win? But Donald Trump does nothing, according to orthodoxy. And he's boasting that he's pretty much got this thing in the bag. Have a listen.
I'm not supposed to say this, you know. I'm going to be like the fake news. They're saying it's very close. It's really not very close. Based on what's been happening, it's not so close. We're leading in all seven swing states, as you probably know.
It's really not very close. I've got this thing in the bag. There's a story on the front page of tomorrow's Australian which says Trump will either be proved to be a genius or a fool. And that little clip will come back either to haunt him or to demonstrate, man, that the guy is an absolute genius.
It does seem an odd way to rev up your base, right? Because, like you said, what you want to do is get people to come out and vote. I mean, I would have thought the number one thing you'd be doing right now is putting the fear of God into people and saying, if you don't come out and vote for me, you could end up with Kamala Harris for president, for heaven's sake. And instead he's saying, no, 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 it's all fine, don't worry about it. Now, he may well be right in that the polls, which currently show it is quite close, particularly in a number of the swing states, are wrong. I think there is still a large contingent of people who are inclined to vote for Trump but almost feel ashamed of the fact that they are inclined to vote for Trump and won't tell pollsters who tend to lean to the left what they actually want to do. But I don't understand why you would use that as your tactic, because the media's going to report that it's close anyway. So what does it help you to go out and say, oh, well, I've got this one in the bag? Interesting, though, was the polling out of Iowa yesterday, which Trump has had in the bag at the last two elections, supposedly showing that that could go to Harris. Now, again, like all of these polls in the swing states, they are within the margin of error. So we don't know. I mean, they could all go to Harris, or they could all go to Trump, or it could be a split down the middle, who knows? Again, it is within the margin of error, but Iowa being in play is not something anyone had ever talked about or thought was going to happen. Who knows what's going on?
I want to know where his confidence coming from, because as much as the polls are looking good for Trump, when you're talking about the seven swing states, the bottom line is nobody knows. Until all the votes are counted, your guess is as good as mine. And that's what all the pollsters basically say to each other. They've all got different, slightly different polls, depending on which pollster you're tuning into. But at the end of the day, the reason why these swing states are called swing states is they're highly unpredictable, and there's a tiny margin separating the winner from the loser. And don't forget, we've got the dodgy Dominion voting machines. You may have seen some of those videos online, people trying to vote for Trump. Yes, it's happening again, and being unable to. We've got some states saying, hang on a minute, we've got more people on our electoral roll than we do have eligible voters in our state. That's a big problem. We've got the DOJ suing several states now who tried to clean up their electoral rolls to get illegals off or people who weren't eligible to vote. So that's going marvellously. I mean, the list of ways in which you're seeing tiny cheats, as well as them not allowing the Republican supervisors to be at polling booths, that was a whole nother schmozzle. All these tiny cheats can go a very long way, depending on which counties. Remember, each of the states look after their own counting methods. Some of them have already flagged, this is going to take us days. Really? Why? This is the 21st century. Why is it going to take you days? And I wouldn't be surprised if this actually drags out for weeks, as we see quite a bit of shenanigans playing out post-election.